اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم صلاح صلاح ان کانگریگیشن حدیث تو پروفٹ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم عائشہ رضی اللہ عنہ نریٹس that رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم said verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends mercy and his angels invoke blessings for those who are on the right hand side of rows Abu Dawood Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, He who stands on the left side of the row in the masjid because of the less number of people on that side gets double the reward. Tabrani Majma'ul Zawaid. Note, as it became known to the Sahaba that the right hand side of the rows carries added virtue, all of them attempted to avail the same, leaving the left hand side empty. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed them about the virtues of standing on the left hand side of the row so that it does not remain incomplete. Faizul Qadir Aisha radiallahu anha narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Verily, Allah sends mercy and his angels invoke blessings for those who fill in the gaps to complete the rows. Mustadrak Hakim Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Whoever joins a row of salah, Allah raises him one rank, and the angels shower Allah's blessings upon him. Tabrani, Targhib. Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, The best of you are those whose shoulders are more soft in salah, and there is no step more rewarding than the step which is taken to fill the gap in the row of Salah. Bazar, Targhib, Ibn Hibban, Tabrani. Note, the meaning of keeping the shoulders soft in Salah is that when somebody tries to enter the row, the persons offering Salah on the right and left should relax their shoulders to let him join the row. Abu Juhayfa radiallahu anhu narrates that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, He who fills the gap in a row of salah is forgiven. He who fills the gap in a row of salah is forgiven. Bazar Majma'ul Zawaid Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhuma narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, He who joins the row of salah, Allah will join him with his mercy. And whoever breaks the row of salah, Allah will cut him away from his mercy. Abu Dawood Note Breaking the row means either placing something personal belongings in the row which would break the continuity of the row or seeing a vacant space and yet not occupying it. Milqatul Mafati Anas radiallahu anhu narrates that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Straighten your rows for the straightening of the rows in salah is essential for the offering of salah correctly. Straighten your rows, for the straightening of the rows in Salah is essential for the offering of Salah correctly. Usman bin Affan radiallahu anhu narrates, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, He who performed wudu for Salah and performed it properly and then went on foot to offer the obligatory Salah and offered it along with the people or in congregation or in the masjid, Allah would forgive his sins. Muslim Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu narrates, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed admires the people offering salah in congregation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed admires the people offering salah in congregation. Musnad Ahmad Majma'ul Zawaid Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, The excellence of a person's salah in congregation is even greater than 20 times as compared to his individual salah. Musnad Ahmad Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, The reward of salah offered by a person in congregation is 25 times greater as compared to that salah offered by him alone in his house or place of business. Bukhari Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhuma narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said Salah in congregation is 27 times greater in reward as compared to Salah offered individually Qubas bin Asyam al-Lathi radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the salah of two persons, with one of them as imam, is more liked by Allah to the individual salah of four persons. Similarly, the salah of four persons, with one of them as imam, is more liked by Allah to the individual salah of eight persons. And the salah of eight persons, with one of them as imam, is more liked by Allah to the individual salah of 100 persons. Bazar, Tabrani, Majmahu Sawai. Ubay bin Ka'b radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the salah of a person offered with another person is better than his salah offered alone, and his salah with two persons is better than his salah offered with one person. Similarly, the larger the number, the more it is liked by Allah, the Almighty, the Majestic. Abu Dawud. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, salah in congregation is equivalent to 25 salah, and when salah is offered in a desert, performing its bowing and prostration properly, it reaches up to 50 times. Abu Dawud. Abu Darda radiallahu anhu narrates, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, if three persons in a village or a forest do not offer the congregational salah, then shaitan fully overpowers them. So make it obligatory on yourself to offer salah in congregation, for undoubtedly the wolf eats only the stray goat. Abu Dawud. Aisha radiallahu anhu narrates that when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam fell ill, he asked for permission from his wives that his nursing be done in my house. They gave him their consent. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam came out with the support of two persons, his feet were making a line on the ground as a result of trailing along. Bukhari. Fazala bin Ubaid radiallahu anhu narrates that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to lead the salah, some people standing in the row would fall down due to extreme hunger. And there were the people of Suffa, about whom the villages would say that they were insane. One day, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam completed the salah, he turned to them and said, if you know the reward that Allah has for you, then you would like to live with more hunger and needs. Fadala says, I was with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam that day. Tirmidhi. Usman bin Affan radiallahu anhu narrates, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying, the one who offered Isha Salat in congregation, it was as if he remained in Salah up to midnight. And if he offered the Fajr Salat in congregation, it was as if he remained in Salah the whole night. Muslim. Note, some scholars on the basis of other ahadith interpret this to mean that he who offers Isha and Fajr Salat both in congregation gets the reward of the whole night's worship. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, indeed, the most burdensome salah for hypocrites is the salah of Fajr and the salah of Isha. Indeed, the most burdensome salah for hypocrites is the salah of Fajr and the salah of Isha. Muslim. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك سبحانك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله